outside pole position. That is up for the Minnesota Park 50. On his outside, the number 12, Jason Miller on a brand man down Minnesota. His third place, the number 9, star Tom Harris out of Menominee. In fourth place, the number 57, John Remington out of White Bear Lake. And in fifth place, unofficially, the number 14 car, Lonnie Lou out of Medford. All right, our next group of cars, they're coming out track side from the backstretch, and that should be our main feature number 2, I do believe. Chris, do you want me to do that?
would have been, I believe, our second B-Main of the night, a 20-lap B-Main for the Superstocks. And right now, we turn it over to the voice of the Cedar Lake Speedway, Chris Steppen.
The top two finishers up to the back of the A. Then we're going to run the Superstock Last Chance race. We're going to run the late model feature first, then the modified feature. Superstock feature will be your concluding event for the 1998 WISSOTA 100. Mater and Kelly Anderson roll three, Dennis Larson and Jody Olson roll four. Finishers 3 through 10 gonna go last chance race right after this. Caution lights do go down over the speedway. Green flag in hand of our flagman Rick Cook in the tower. Watch for Bob Gertes and Mike Hernke setting the pace for B feature number two. Out of form will come to the chalk line. Green flag out for Bob in contact in turn three. The one car, 47 flag, does come out for your leader, Bob Gertes. Ron Mayer, right at the drop in the green, drops to the bottom of the speedway. He's going to battle up here in Ocean for third. Bob Gertes got about a three-car lead over Ron Bader, who's now in second. Larry Baumeister drops back to third. Eric Olson and Mike Hernke rounding out one more time. Bob Gertes, Ron Bader, and Larry Baumeister, your top three. Bader now looking to the bottom of the speedway. He's going to go up try to challenge Bob Gertes for the lead. Now looking low down from a three wide out of four. Mike Hernke, Eric Olson, and Rick Bishop. by Ron Nader for second. Your winner will be Bob Davies. Ron Nader does come in second. So your top five finishers in B feature number two. Mike Hernke comes home fifth in the 1H car. Rich Bishop was fourth. Larry Baumeister came home third in the two that transferred to the A main tonight. Don Mader in K1 came home second. And your winner from Ramsey, Minnesota, Bob Gardies. All right, last chance race on the Speedway. We're going to take the winner to the back of the A main later on this afternoon. Cars you see on the Speedway on the pole, the 57. John Remington to his outside, the 4B, that's Larry Baumeister. Next row on the inside, the 1H, Mike Hernke to his outside, the 10 car, Rich Bishop. Row 3 on the inside, the 14 is Lonnie Liu, to his outside, the 33, Dennis Larson. Row 4 on the inside, the 2R, Jeff Reed, to his outside, Jody Olson, driver of the number 7. Row 5 on the inside, the 21A, that's Justin Alward, to his outside, the 86, Don Falls. Row 6 on the inside looks to be the 3G of Joe Bean and the 4 car of Paul Erickson.
All righty, Chris, thank you very much. And we go down that backstretch heading toward that third corner. We keep that front line side by side. Remington on the inside. We come to the line. We go to green. Tells me there's real hope for this track this afternoon. If we can keep running all over it, we'll be in great shape. Watching our cars now between 3 and 4. Out of 4, it's still the 57. John Remington in the lead. B car, Larry Baumeister out of Hudson, Wisconsin in second place, and in third place, it's the number 10, Rich Bishop out of Ladysmith. So far, so good. Baumeister down inside, and now we got a car doing, almost a 360, not quite. Baumeister out of Hudson, and in third, as we go to green, the 10 of Rich Bishop. Hoping that they can find some moisture up there. But if we get enough black down on this track, folks, let's just face it, we'll be able to race all over it again. Raw Remington man still in the lead. Larry Baumeister back in second and Rich Bishop in third. Staying exactly the same. A couple of the drivers going way, way high up on top of the cushion. Trying to cool tires down a little bit. Trying to grab a hold of something, hoping that it'll propel them out of these corners. The old slingshot effect. Last night, I'll tell you folks, it was working. We had some drivers coming on the high side right against the cushion and coming out of those corners and really motivating down the backstretch. Into the A main, only the top driver. Change here. Oh, unbelievable. John Remington cuts her down on the inside. He gets his spot back. Watch this change off. Larry Baumeister now down on the inside. He drifts high. John Remington underneath them. They're side by side going down the backstretch. Remington back into the lead. Hey, folks, you want a fun race to watch? This is it. Look at these two top drivers battling it out here. Baumeister and Remington. The four car, Larry Baumeister out of Hudson, John Remington. One goes high, they just keep trading off back and forth. Baumeister now holding on to that lead. Watch out. John, you spin yourself out, which is what you did, and you have just lost it, my friend. A tough, tough break for John Remington in the number 50. Jerry O'Brien. We go back to green. We're going to try this again, our last chance, the last opportunity for one driver to get up into the back of the A-Main this afternoon for the WISSOTA Super Stock cars. The driver that has been up toward the front for the last couple laps leading this one, of course, the number 4, Larry Baumeister out of Hudson. In second place, the number 10, Rich Bishop. And in third, it's still the 7 car of Jody Olson out of Hibbing. Rich Bishop, the number 10 car on the corner, tried coming down on the inside, seeing if he could get up alongside Larry Baumeister. Did not happen. He backed out of it and is at this point willing to follow along behind. But he knowing very well, almost tied with Joe Bean out of Zimmerman, Minnesota. They're really side-by-side racing for that third position. White flag is down, folks, and you have got it. Our 20 laps is just 15. Okay, 15 laps, just about into the history book. Right now, Larry Baumeister with a pretty sizable lead, but the number 10, Rich Bishop, not willing to give up. All right, here we go. Tire right in front of everybody. It is simple. Give you the top five again. Larry Baumeister starting outside pole position. Larry out of Hudson, he will be the one progressing up into the very back of the A-Main here this afternoon. In second place, the number 10, Rich Bishop out of Ladysmith, Wisconsin. In third place, the number 7, Jody Olson out of Hibbing. In fourth place, the number 3, Joe Bean out of Zimmerman, Minnesota. And in fifth place, the 86 car, and that is Don Fultz out of Rice Lake. Gentlemen, apparently Bob Cook down trackside, he'll be taking apparently just a little of the lip off the cushion. In other words, knocking the cushion down a bit.
All getting their helmets on, safety straps down. Gonna wait for your pollster in the late models to tell me when he's ready. We'll give the command. All right, on three, you can help me out here. 1, 2, 3, gentlemen, set your engines.
Outside.
a special bunch, and that we've assembled here this afternoon to watch them do their stuff here for the WISSOTA 100. Look at that front row, and look on back, all the way to the very back, the finest and best in dirt track drivers, right here for the WISSOTA 100. Their cars will hold together. All these drivers hoping that they will make the right decision. And obviously, through the course of a 20, 30, or 40 lap event, they are making thousands of decisions. Each and every one of them hoping it's the right one. They'll be making one more lap around. If you just stay to your feet and keep on waving, the drivers suck this up, folks. They love it when you stand for them and wave at them and whatever. They enjoy it a whole bunch. It's always a special time, the Parade of Champions here at the WISSOTA 100. The Canadian flags flying high from the inside pace truck, the U.S. flags on the outside. And our joint experience we have back and forth in the racing community between Canada and the U.S., and we love it. Appreciate our drivers going up there, Canadian drivers coming down here. Now, let's say goodbye to the WISSOTA Superstocks as they head off into the pit area. They will be going off to the right back in the pit area with our two classes remaining. Again, ladies and gentlemen, 79 cars, the WISSOTA Parade of Champions. You've got it right, folks. The late models this year on the inside. The late models will be running their race first. Late models will be first, then the modifieds, then the super stocks.
Featured tonight on the pole, the 50 car from Nassau, Minnesota, Jeff Wellman. On the outside, the 09, Mike Chemernick. Rick Egersdorf Thursday evening. Caution lights. You go down over the speedway. Green flag going to come up. Green flag.
was trying to go by some back markers. Contact made with the back marker. You see him sitting up on the outside wall in turn four. Going pretty well so far. A couple good battles around the speedway. See if the 09 has tough mechanical problems or if he'll be able to continue in this one. Looks like a little bit of damage on the nose of the 09. On your leader, the 09 car, tough break for him. The 17 car, Rick Egersdorf. The green comes out for Rick Egersdorf, your leader. I don't think anybody was ready for the green, but Egersdorf, the leader, hits the gas with a diamond on track. Time, the 46 of John Camp and the 5 car, MJ McBride.
Your leader, Rick Egersdorf. White flag coming out now for Rick Egersdorf. Bunch of cars get together, mid-pack, brings out yellow flag. So are we done? It will come out over the speedway, apparently. We're going to finish on the white flag. The winner will be Rick Egersdorf. Not sure on the exact official lineup here. I'm going to check it out in the crowd. Jeff Wilbon does come home second.
Tom Nesbitt, get over here. Tom, get up here. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Thunder Bay Zone, Tommy Nesbitt. That's what I just told the people. I said, Tom, did you see that tire?
I just looked at it just now. Oh, man. You were one lap away from being one very disgruntled Tom Nesbitt.
Gotta believe it. I'm one lap away from being last.
Well, you didn't have time to go all the way to the back, probably, but you wouldn't have been in third. This has been a long jaunt. The WISSOTA 100 is a lot of work for you drivers, and but yet to win or to be in the top three, I was just thinking about that. I mean, you'd like to be up front, the number one. You'd love to have been up front, but let's just face it. We had like 60-some late models. If you can be in the top three of 60-some late models, Tom, it's just nothing to be anything but happy about.
You got that right. I'm happy about finishing three. When you see how many cars they have to turn away, I just wish they come up with some better way so we could all race, you know, and it wouldn't have sent so many people home. I think that if we just had time trials and then three feature races for the top 75 in times, that at least we'll get more cars in a feature. And the people still see as many racing, and there won't be so many delays and restarts. I think we got to change this format so more people make some money.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'll probably get fired walking back up the announcer's booth, but you had your say, and that is totally fair. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, Tommy Nesbitt, third place today, gotta be a thrilled guy. Jeff, get on up here. Let's get up front so people can see you a little bit. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Jeff Roldong. Well, we've already talked about the 60 cars, and being in the top three has got to be a great thrill. Did you stay here last night, or did you come back in this morning?
Oh, we stayed here last night. We figured we'd back up, we'd be sitting there.
When you come into a race like this, knowing instead of a nice, tacky night race, it's going to be the way it is, there's just no way to get around it. Do you have any idea that you'd be able to hold on to your positioning when you started?
Well, it's tough when you start on the pole, and everybody said, you know, from the beginning of the weekend, Rick was going to be the guy to beat, and I guess we thought if we could stay in front of him, we'd have it. You know, Shamrock had a tough time there. I don't know what happened, but I guess Rick probably would have been the guy to beat anyway. He found it, and he was gone.
What are we at for sponsors? All good for 99 or same folks from this year or what?
I'm sure we'll have something a little different. Vite Companies out of Minneapolis there, Rogers. That's one of my main ones right now. And Tom's Backo, Budweiser. I got a bunch of them here after five and back home. And my biggest one's Bullet Chassis.
Cars work for you, obviously.
Yeah, I guess Ray Callahan's did a ton for us. They had a tough time. Their boy died on them, but they got things going again.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, out of Nassau, Minnesota, Jeff Wildung. Thank you, Jeff. Golly. Okay, now this was all staged. What did I tell you to do last weekend? Get over here. Now you got to come over here. They can take their pictures later. What did I tell you to do?
Well, you said wait.
No, what did I tell you to do? You got to do it first. You got to grab the microphone in my hand and just go to it and talk.
All right. Greg wants me to do his job. I guess I'll do it. I guess the key to the whole race was the first 10 laps and Mike Chamernick's misfortune, because it would have been really tough to pass him. The other pass I had to make was Walding, and he got outside of me just a little bit there, so I snuck inside, and the race was basically over in about 15 laps, which I knew it would be, but at least we had a little bit of racetrack to race on. Now, you won't see the same type of thing in the feature for the other two classes because they don't hold the rubber like our cars do, so you'll see a lot of wide racing is what I'm hoping to see, so you guys will see a good show. Thank you.
Rick, what is this about? You got to tell me who this is.
This is my daughter, Leah. She doesn't get to go to many races, but she was here tonight and really rooting me on. Felt really good to have her here.
You've never had anybody standing in front of you holding up trophies for you. That's got to be a thrill.
You bet.
Ladies and gentlemen, our late model 1998 13th Annual WISSOTA 100 winner. Let's hear it one more time out of Lake Elma, Minnesota. It's Rick Egersdorf.
Greg's down there getting his victory lane photo taken. We're going to run through the finishing order. I do have the official order now. 24th on the field, the 28P, Jeff Provenzino. 23rd will be the 00, Mitch Johnson. 22nd, the 8S, Larry Stockwell. 21st, the 19, Steve Larson. 20th, 31, Kelly Estee. 19th, 52, Rick Tennis. 18th will be the 7C, Dwayne Clark. 17th, 51, Joel Kreiderman. He and Jesse Klug, who finishes 16th, were charged with that yellow flag there on the last lap. MJ McBride finishes in front of them in the 5 car. Next up was the 71, Jerry Leggett. 32, Terry Anvilink. 46, John Canta. 31, Randy Gullickson. Your 10th place finisher, the 11, Pat Doerr. Ashley Anderson finishes 9th and 81. John Kershinsky was 7th and 15. 6th place, the QQ. Seventh place, QQ, Tony Barr. Sixth place, 3J, Don Kopp. Fifth place, 27, Jerry Radetsky. Fourth place, 2, Mike Nutzman. Tom Nesbitt does finish third. You saw him just drive to the pits with a right rear flat tire. Sitting getting in victory lane with a flat tire. Second place was the 50 of Jeff Wildung, and of course, your 1998 WISSOTA 100 late model feature winner, the 17, Rick Egersdorf.
the lights do go down over the Speedway. Just about to go back. Modified racing. 17 laps have been completed. Green flag off of your leader, Steve Wick.
It's hard with all the noise down front, but Cedar and Stephanie and all the kids that participated, congratulations to all of them. Out of four, we're back with a green flag. Can't believe Chris Steppen. Just can't get over that dude. Cleans up good for a young kid. Let's go down. He said, yeah, I'm still John, Chris. Don't worry about it. Let's go down trackside now. Ooh, tough break. Wheel tire just sort of pulled right off. Ouch. Tough, tough break. Let's go down trackside right now to Chris Steppen.
All right, thank you. We are down here with the third place finisher. He hails from Stratford, Wisconsin. Let's give him a round of applause. Troy Kuyev. Having a great season so far everywhere. Saw you here a couple times earlier this season. Ran very strong both times you were here. How many feature wins do you have this season?
This is 25. I was hoping for 26 today, but it didn't come out. But day racing, it's tough to pass. But I'd like to thank my sponsors, Paul Obbs. He helps me out, built my motors. The car was great because of him and the best of my crew. And Colbert Chassis does a great job. So.
25 feature wins, he says he has. That's a pretty good season. What are your plans for the rest of the 1998 racing season?
Well, we got six races to go. We're going to try to win a couple yet and win the championship, so we'll see how things go.
All right, he's in the thick of it for the WISSOTA Modified National Championship. One more time, the 80 car, Troy Kuya. All right, your second place finisher, he just told me what I was going to ask him. He says I don't race out here enough, but boy, every time he shows up here, he runs very strong. Comes here just about one time a season for this annual race, the WISSOTA 100. Usually near the front, he hails from Herman, Minnesota, the 5X, Scott Danzeason. Like I said, we don't see him here very often. Comes here for the WISSOTA 100. Run real strong. Great race today. It is tough to pass on a day race, kind of a one-lane track, but you stuck your nose in there. Tried to go to the outside of Steve Wick a few times. He was pretty powerful coming out the corner. The bottom was the place to be.
Yeah, it was a one lane. I wish I could have got by him, but on an afternoon deal like this, I guess you just got to get in the line and hope the guy in front of you makes a mistake.
All right, Steve Wick, local competitor here. He knows this place, knows how to get around here. Great race for you. Congratulations. What are your plans for the rest of the season?
All right, this will be our last show for the year. I'm so busy at work and with some other stuff that we'll park her for the winter.
Well, not a bad way to end the season then. One more time, let's let him hear it. Scott Danzeason. Gonna come up and talk to your feature winner. Picking up his first win of the 1998 season. Runs here every Saturday night over at the Red Cedar Speedway on Friday nights. Let's let him hear it from Downsville, Wisconsin, the number 11, Steve Wick. Guess starting on the pole was to your advantage today. The bottom was the place to be. It is tough to pass here in an afternoon race, but racing here every single week must come to your advantage. You know how to get around this place, know what the track's going to do on an afternoon show.
The pole was the key.
The pole was the key. Well, it was a good deal to win your heat race the other night then. So you redrew the pole. Deb Weinfurter, pretty good to you on the redraw over there. You're going to have to thank her for this one. Some sponsors you'd like to thank?
Geertz Racing, Budweiser, Sam's Auto Supply, Cobra, PC Wizardry, everybody that helps me.
All right. What are your plans for the rest of the season? I've asked everybody else. Might as well ask you, too.
Think about this one, I guess, for a while.
Picking up his biggest feature win of his career, the number 11, Steve Wick.
All right, they are down trackside. Shortage. Seriously, that was a big deal, folks, on the national news. Herman, Minnesota. Trying to get more women to move out in western Minnesota. I just assumed maybe you were one of the guys. How was I to know? All right, all the pictures being taken. Not to mention any names or anything. Super stocks, ready to do battle. Rick Egersdorf talked earlier about hoping that the modified and super stock drivers would be able to race inside, outside, wherever. We'll see how it goes during this one. We hope what he says exactly will be the truth. Again, it's Gangle on the inside. Steve Holmquist on the outside in that first row. You got to be happy if you're on the pole, and yet you know it is your responsibility whether you go to green or not. And I'll tell you, when you're up front, there's not a whole lot of excuse for spinning out, so there's a little added pressure up front to do your very best. You can't hide as you come to line. We go to green. Last feature of today's races. It's Gangle again on the inside. See, Hulk was on the outside in that first row. Gangle, of course, being on the inside, comes out of that second corner, three or four car lengths ahead of the 3B of Steve Holmquist. Watch them as they come out of that fourth corner. Everybody taking it a little bit easy here. Get the new Dustin developed to get it burned off and sent eastward. Track has been smooth. That's one thing we can say. There's been no chuck holes or grooves or anything else. It's been a very, very smooth track we've had to work with here this afternoon. Dale Gangle, the 34 car, still our lead car. The 05 car, Chucky D. Smith, back in second. Locks in the 23 car, Stone Lake, Wisconsin, in third. And in fourth place, the three car, Steve Holmquist. Right now, the number 12, Mike Goodreboot, going to the high side. Knowing very well he cannot go through people down on the inside, wondering if he could possibly do something on the high side. We'll see what happens this afternoon, watching him up there, if he in fact is going to go forward or backward. I'm not this. Off our fourth corner, still Dale Gangle, the 34 car, in the lead. Chucky D. Smith back in second, Keenan Loxton in third, and in fourth place, the three again, the 3B, Steve Holmquist. Little rapping and tapping over on the back stretch with the 72 car, Dave Moss out of Breeder, Minnesota. The number three car off the track surface, and he really needs to just pull in line and go racing because he might just be sitting there for a while. The number 24 car heading off the track, Jake Kittner out of Hibbing, Minnesota, heading into the pit area. Another car spinning out, the 41 car in the fourth corner. Mark Teske. Mark sits there with that front left tire almost over the edge. And green, folks, one more time for the Superstocks. It's Gangle in the lead, Chucky D. Smith back in that second position, which is the same way. Keenan Loxton back in third, Steve Holmquist in fourth, and in fifth place, John Daly. Champion Mike Goodreboot heading down into pit road, the number 12, out of this event. Peter Smith back in second. Keenan Loxton, the 23 in third. We are halfway, 15 up and 15 down, folks. John Daly, the 94 car, back in fifth place. In sixth place, the 88 of Bobby Houston. Seventh place, the 15 car. The double checker for the rest of the crew of three more other cars. Now we got a Melbourne. Go ahead, Chris.
Just waiting for the third place finisher, Keen Loxton, to get out of his car, getting his helmet off down here. Other two finishers already out of their cars, waiting for their victory lane celebration. Out of the car. There he is. He's out of the car. He hails from Stone Lake, Wisconsin. Let's let him hear it. The 23, Keen Loxton. Don't get to see you very often this season. This must be your first trip here this season.
Yeah, it is. We're usually up in Ashland or St. Croix, and it was just a real treat to come down here. All we want to do is try and make the feature, and here we are up here. Can't ask for anything more.
All right. Sponsors you'd like to thank?
Mystery Chassis, Dale Cunnington builds the car for me. Hayward Home Center, Stone Lake Oil, Bubba's Auto Salvage, Vortance. I mean, every one of them means so much to having these cars out here. We can't thank them enough.
All right, pretty happy guy. Let's let him hear it. Keen Loxton. Chucky D. Smith finishes second here, the 05. He runs here locally every Saturday night, kind of an up and down season. Had pretty good runs, and then I know he had a pretty bad wreck about mid-season, took a few weeks off. Pretty good run here tonight.
Thanks. Yeah, the track came right into what we hoped it would, and we had everything together for a change, and everything stayed together, so it makes a difference.
Go ahead and thank some sponsors.
I'd like to thank Lehman and Larson and LPI Trucking, Scuddy's Detour, OB's Repair, and Glenwood City Ford, and Schaefer Oil.
All right, what do you have planned for the rest of the 1998 racing season?
Well, I'm going to run the Punky next week and then go to Ashland, and hopefully we can sell the car.
Oh, I bet after a run like that, a lot of people interested in this car. Let's let them hear it, Chucky D. Smith. Going to let Dale Gangle have another photo or two taken. We're going to jump in here, talk to him. He hails from Cedar, Minnesota, former track champion here.
Once again, pretty good starting on the pole tonight.
Yeah, I guess that was the place to start, wasn't it?
Seemed to be. Steve Wick had the same thing in mind, liked starting on the pole. Led every single lap, had a real good season here, picked up track championship down the road over in St. Croix. Ran very strong here, picked up several feature wins, picked up a pretty big one tonight.
Yeah, the biggest of my career.
Any sponsors you'd like to thank?
Yeah, there sure is. TNT, Precision Machining, Wayright Electric, Ray's Small Engine, and Cylinder Head.
All right, and what else for you the rest of this season?
I'm heading out to Jamestown next weekend and Aberdeen the following weekend.
All right, going to make a swing through the Dakotas. Cleaned up here at the Cedar Lake Speedway. Let's let them hear it. Your feature winner, Dale Gangle.
Well, right now, ladies and gentlemen, they'll be getting ready to go take some pictures, and I'd like to again thank our 4 to 6 year old in their coloring contest. Now for the 7 to 9, Lindsay Gaber from the Red Cedar Speedway, our first place finisher. Derek Schubert out of the Proctor Speedway, our second place finisher in the 7 through 9 year old bracket. And Mac Estee out of Hibbing, the Hibbing Raceway, in third in that bracket. From the 10 to 12 year olds, Carol Wedden, I believe, our first place finisher out of Proctor Speedway. Skeeter Estee out of the Grand Rapids Speedway, our second place finisher. And in third place, Brandon Distel out of the Rice Lake Speedway, living out of Apple Valley, Minnesota. So we'd like to thank all our kids that submitted their different pictures that they drew, or coloring contests, you know what I'm saying, that they had at the various tracks. And so all the kids that put their entries in at their various tracks, the different track winners came here. And we'd also really like to thank our people that did the voting. Very, very difficult, not easy. Ken Knoll and Faye Henricks, and I believe Jerry O'Brien were the people that got to do the voting on the process, and it was not easy for them. They were so good. So all the kids, all of you, you did an excellent job, and be sure next year for the big race against drugs and also the coloring contest in conjunction with each other. Be sure to do that again next year, because I know you have a lot of fun with that, and we really appreciate all the kids here. Still down trackside, taking a few more pictures. We'd again like to thank, talking about the folks from Bart Wheels, from Conoco, Sunoco Racing Fuels, and Hoosier Tires. So we appreciate that. And I know we have some folks in the pit area from Masterbuilt Race Car, late model cars in the pit area. I'd like to thank those folks also. Still down trackside with our top three super stock drivers. And to all the drivers in the pit area, whether you won an event or were 33rd, I really don't care. To all of you, we say thank you for your involvement with the 1998 13th Annual WISSOTA 100. You've come from a long way, many of you. Some of you have come out of here with some change in your pocket and a good feeling in your heart. Some of you have worked awful hard. You've had misfortune or accidents or a cut tire or who knows what. But to all of you, we say thank you. You all did a great job and have been good sportsmen. And to all the crowd all the way around this track for last night sticking with us and being so unbelievably cooperative, I say thank you to all of you. We hope that in 1999 you'll be back with us for the WISSOTA 100, the bidding process for where the WISSOTA 100 will be. It will be out here soon, and so that'll be, of course, a notification on that later on of where the WISSOTA 100 will be in 1999, but we trust wherever it is, be it Cedar Lake here or wherever, that you'll be with us for the 1999. On behalf of our WISSOTA board, who has worked this now 5-day program, I'd very much like to thank Don Rosine, the first vice president of WISSOTA and also the race director of the last 5 days. To Debbie Weinfurtner, our treasurer from WISSOTA, she's also the late model and super stock point director. Debbie, over on the far side, after a grueling time over in the pit area for you, I say thank you for all your work. For Sue Emmons, she is a street stock point director and also in charge of the coloring contest. Sue, for all the work you put in on everything, we do say thank you. Eric Erickson from ABC up in Ashland, he's a PR person. Eric, thanks for your help in getting lists together and that sort of thing. And also Randy Buss. Randy, we didn't have a whole lot of chance to talk with you, but he's the head tech inspector for WISSOTA. He's the guy that gets a lot of the phone calls and the gripes and complaints. Randy, for all your work, thank you. Continued success in all that you're doing. Also, Jackie Buss, thanks for all your work at the ticket windows here. And, of course, Joyce Rosine, the recording secretary, who we had a chance to talk to a little bit earlier this afternoon. She is also the Mod 4 and Championship Sprint Point Director for WISSOTA. So for Joyce, for all the help you gave me, and again, getting lists together and stuff, faxing me material, I appreciate it so, so much. Ladies and gentlemen, as you're heading back to your motorhomes and back up to Ontario, Manitoba, the Dakotas, Wyoming, Minnesota, wherever it might be, or if you live right here in Star Prairie, we'd like to say thank you seriously for your attendance in this 13th annual WISSOTA 100. And at this point in time, on behalf of Chris Steppen and myself, Greg Nordwall, we say again, sincerely, a thank you. Have a great fall. There's a lot of racing coming up in the next few weeks here in Wisconsin and in the Dakotas. So be sure to keep going racing on the weekends. And we hope to also see you at the WISSOTA Banquet coming up in St. Cloud, Minnesota on Saturday night, the 7th of November. Again, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. Have a great afternoon, a great fall, and we'll see you racing in the coming year. Good night.
Cedar Lake Racing Videos by Dan Nienaber. Oops, wait a minute. By Paul Joan and Dan Nienaber. A presentation of Nothing Fancy Videos. A division of Unconscious Engineering, and a member in good standing of the Day Late and a Dollar Short racing team. Please, give me a break. I'm just a working stiff trying to earn a buck. If you make copies of this video, you are just taking money out of my pocket. Thanks for your honesty. Nothing Fancy Videos, 1818 East 3rd Street, St. Paul, Minnesota, 55119. Our telephone number is area code 651-738-7986. Please note the new area code, 651. That's Nothing Fancy Videos, 1818 East 3rd Street, St. Paul, Minnesota, 55119, telephone number, area code 651, telephone number 738-7986. That's 651-738-7986. When you call to ask about videos, please ask for Joan. Thanks very much.